Well, welcome back there, Reject Nation. Greg Alba here.
Cat Alvarado.
Cat Alvarado, comedian, lady. I mean, there's got to be a much more appropriate way to say that. Funny female.
Funny person. I'm a funny person.
Human being with a sense of humor is here.
No way. Women aren't funny.
Women aren't funny. What kind of bullshit is this we have in here?
You only think I'm a woman because I told you.
Cat Alvarado, the Cat Alvarado on Twitter and Instagram. You can follow her there. Nah, she's a comedian. I saw her at Flappers ages ago. You can catch some of her stand-up online. You know what I'm going to do for you? I'm going to put a link in the description box to see one of her stand-ups because it's genuinely funny.
Thank you.
Wouldn't have invited her on if she was not funny. No pressure to be funny right now, of course. Be yourself. Let the video do the talking of her actual stand-up material. And I'm gonna do a Patron of the Day shout-out at the end of this video for Dylan Fawn Thomas.
Dylan!
Hey, Kat, you know a thing or two about comedy?
I do!
There's a movie coming out called The Hitman's Bodyguard. Mm-hmm. I saw a few trailers for this already. I think you might enjoy it. Have you, you've heard of Ryan Reynolds?
I have.
You've heard of Samuel L. Jackson?
Yes.
Well, they're together in this one.
Oh my god.
Have you seen any of these trailers?
No, I haven't, but that sounds like when they put meatball and marinara sauce together, aka like it is going to be delicious to watch.
Metaphors. Let's do this.
This is Michael Bryce. I'm an executive protection agent. I've extracted my client. Cleanup is required. You might want to call the bomb squad.
Oh, no.
Maybe the fire department.
Is that my car?
I'm afraid so. Have a seat. It's been a long day.
The trial continues one of the world's most brutal dictators.
With a key witness to testify.
I can assure you, we're more than prepared for any assault.
Prepared for that assault, motherfucker?
Motherfucker. Kincaid is dead. You'll be paid in full.
There's a safe house not far from here.
I have a job for you.
The transport is in there.
What the fuck?
Times. That's how many times this asshole's tried to kill me. 27. 28!
You'll last 1 hour without me.
You gonna be a little bitch about it?
Tell us where your husband is.
You lost my husband? That is your job, motherfucker.
The only way Bryce and Kincaid don't make it so they kill each other first.
Three, one. My bad. You're bad.
Oh, well, life gives you shit. You make Kool-Aid.
Life doesn't usually give you shit and then turn into a beverage.
It's those little jokes like that at the end that I'm looking forward to most in this movie.
Yes.
So I've seen a couple of trailers of this. I've given my opinion, and there's only so much opinions you can give off of these trailers since it's a very simple premise. Kat, interested in your thoughts.
I want to see that movie.
Really?
It looks amazing.
Oh, yeah.
I'm so excited.
Is that your honest opinion? I'm having a hard time telling that.
I know I sound sarcastic, but no, for real, though. I don't like boring movies. I don't like rom-coms. I don't like dramas. I only like things that are funny and exciting, right? I don't know. Maybe that says something about, like, my mental health. I need stimulation. Whatever.
We don't need to go that deep.
We don't need to go there. But, this movie seems like it is, like, exciting and funny. And since we all have ADD these days, it's perfect.
It's perfect.
It's perfect.
It looks kinetic. It looks nonstop.
I was gonna say Canadian.
It looks Canadian. Well, Ryan Reynolds is Canadian.
He is. Oh my god.
It looks like it's gonna progressively get crazier as the film keeps on going, which is my kind of movie right there.
I just want to keep watching them fight.
Yeah, I mean, I just want
to. And then be mean to each other.
and then get along in the end.
And they, like, get over their differences. Yeah. Oh my God, is this gonna have deeper themes that, like, connect to our nation as a whole, and then, like, how we can come together? Oh my God, if they do, I'm gonna contact that screenwriter and be like, hey, can you teach me your ways? Because that's brilliant. That'd be creepy. I'm not gonna do that. Yeah. I'm not gonna do that.
You don't need to change your voice either when you do that. Yeah.
But I'm gonna think about it. I have high hopes that, this movie's gonna really give me some insight about life and our country. Is that a lot to put on a movie?
It's a little, maybe read a little too far into it. Just a tad bit. I think, though, as a simple comedy, it looks like it's gonna deliver on comedy and action.
Action. A lot of action.
I could see you doing action. I could see you doing, like, action comedy. I could see you doing that.
Yeah, like, what the, you know, Deadpool version of Wonder Woman? I could see
Wonder Woman?
Wonder Woman. Yeah.
Now stick your tongue out on camera, you're gonna get a lot more viewers. That's the way to do it.
Is it? Sweet.
Any slight sexual thing you do, get a lot more viewers.
Oh no.
That's simple. Doesn't work for me when I do it. That's the sad part there.
You've tried?
I've tried. I've got it naked on this channel before.
Really?
I have one video where there's only a sock around my penis. Wow. Did not increase my following.
Could you link to that below?
Yeah, sure.
Cool.
I'm sorry. For all you people who are gonna watch that now, we just have to find out what that video is.
You're welcome.
Yeah. I mean, this looks like an entertaining, good time. Sure. The action looks awesome. The con, there's only so much. I'm just gonna repeat myself.
Oh, from Selma Hayek. Can I just say Selma? She looks amazing. She's always been hot. I remember she was hot when I was an infant in the early 90s, and she doesn't look like she's changed. Is she a vampire? That is insane. Like, if I was a dude, I would want to marry Salma Hayek so hard.
Oh, yeah, definitely. I would marry her hard, for sure. Salma Hayek was a vampire in one movie.
That is true.
From Dusk Till Dawn, where she had sexy dancing. She still does look sexy. Hispanic women age well. You're Hispanic.
I am Hispanic.
Nicaraguan.
Nicaraguense.
And that means you're going to age well.
I hope. Did you guys know that I'm 80?
Yeah, for 80, you look really damn good. You're like the hottest senior citizen I've seen in a long time.
That's it. Nicaragua does
like
to you.
You, then like Helen Mirren right there. And then like Jennifer Aniston.
It's because my people drink baby blood.
Ooh. Ooh.
We don't. FYI, we
segue.
Don't.
Subscribe to The Real Rejects. Click that notification bell. Hey, the Cat Alvarado. At the Cat Alvarado, where she's getting Cat Alvarado'd on Instagram and Twitter. Mm-hmm. And Cat Alvarado Comedy on her Facebook page. I follow her. You should follow her, too. Because if I do it, you should do it. And in that shout-out we were talking about, Dylan Fawn Thomas. Oh, patron of the day over here.
Sounds hot.
Dylan Fawn Thomas is hot.
He sounds sexy.
He is sexy. I could show you a photo of Dylan Fawn Thomas right now. He's your kind of guy.
He looks like a cuddler.
He is a cuddler.
He looks like a cuddler.
Probably with a thick dick, too. Yeah, cuddler with a thick dick. Those are like the two qualities every woman wants. Cat can vouch for this.
Totally.
You know, a little chubby, cuddly, with a thick penis.
He looks so cuddly.
Why didn't you comment on the second thing that I've been bringing up?
That's weird. I don't want to comment.
Come on. Your comedy is all penis jokes.
It's mostly penis jokes.
You don't have any original
thick
material.
Dick. Yeah, everyone wants a thick dick. That we do. That's
true. You, Dylan Fawn Thomas.
It's you.
I'm sorry I put you in this position.
It's fine. Women have to deal with this all the time.
As you should.